behalf of the whole team, as one of the three seniors here on the team, I just want to say thank you guys for a great, amazing season. It's been an incredible 5 years here. You guys have seen my growth over those times. You know, I just want to thank you guys for sticking with me and also the team. Being here loud and proud and supporting us every night. It means a lot to us.
Thank you!
Why we're playing the way we're playing is, you know, the guy that right of me is, he is passing the basketball so well. You know, he's still going to get his 20, 22 shots, but, I mean, he is passing the basketball, you know, with the double teams he's getting, with the hedges on the screens. He's playing really unselfish basketball. And a lot of his passes don't lead to assists, but they're what we call hockey assists. You know, it's leading to the next guy being wide open. You know, when two teams are coming, when two guys are at him and he kicks the next guy, we've gotten teams in scramble modes. I just think he's playing at such an elite level that it's really hard to guard us when he's passing the ball like he is.
Coach, what makes Marcus Howard so difficult to guard? 37 points today.
Oh, man. I tell you what, like, I would have paid a ticket to watch these two kids play today. You know, I think what I've always been so impressed with Marcus, and he's young, I didn't know he was as young as he is his stamina. I think that's what I've always been most impressed about. You know, he's a phenomenal player. He gets beat up, he gets whacked on plays, but I think the fact that he's able to do it, I think that's why, you know, him and Marcus are elite basketball players, is that the ability to make a play when you've played 36 minutes and you got to take a shot and make it, I think that's what makes him elite.
Speaking of Marcus, Miles the last been made. I know you guys could still play in New York, but what was it like competing for maybe the final time?
I mean, it was just a dream come true when you grow up in Jersey and you have a fellow Dave that's just, I mean, we've been in the league the same 4 years. I mean, we watch each other grow. I mean, if there's anybody in the league right now that I compare my success to, is him. I mean, he's a heck of a player. So, I mean, he's a great dude on and off the court. And like I told him at the end, don't let this ruin your moment. You deserve this. And I just sent him love and prayers as well.
You know, all plays like that, everybody better watch out. I mean, they were terrific. And they had answers for everything we did. They were incredible. And if Mamu plays like that, and you got Mamu and Powell and a bunch of guys who star in their role, the NCAA better watch out, because if they play like that, they're gonna be tough to beat. And you know, I tip my cap to Kevin and them. I mean, they were terrific. I mean, obviously, you know, there's things that you will look at, and we can do better and we can be better. But a lot of today had to do with Seton Hall and how good they were.
Yeah, obviously they shot up 52%. What makes them so difficult to guard? How are they getting such easy shots?
Well, they're a paint team. I mean, if you look at their stats through however many games they've played to this point, they've shot 32% from three. Yeah, you know, with the exception of Powell, there are other guys have been guys who score in paint. And tonight, everything they threw up seemingly went in. And so, we ran into a buzzsaw.
The moment you step on campus, he's only been here a year, but like he mentioned, I mean, it feels like he's been here before. I mean, the amount of effort, the amount of work, the amount of unselfishness that he's put into this program is equivalent to a 4-year player. So. To even be on the same team with SM and to compete with him every day, it's been an honor. You know, I'm so thankful to have a guy like Jace who does all the dirty work. Might not get a lot of the accolades or praise, but I mean, he just does whatever it takes to win. And to have a guy like that on your team, I mean, he's someone you couldn't trade or wouldn't you want to trade. I mean, he's an unbelievable person, an unbelievable player, so I'm fortunate to have him. And then, you know, Sack, I mean, it's funny because Sack is the only person on our team who has been here since I got here. I think that says a lot. You know, you really understand and know who people in your life who really care about you and really believe in you are when they stick with you through tough times. And Sack has been one of the most loyal people, teammates I've ever had on my team. And to see him come in each and every day and work his butt off, I mean, I don't think I've ever been around another person who works as hard and doesn't get enough credit for it. I mean, you guys are seeing that his development over 5 years, but I see it on a daily basis. The amount of work he puts in, the amount of time he spends perfecting his craft. And, you know, as a kid who's younger who looks up to a guy like that, I mean, I think that's like the consummate big brother type. I mean, he's been like a big brother to me, you know, to have a guy like that who's been here for 5 years. I mean, that's someone I look up to. I mean, we're on the same team, but yeah, I mean, Sack has influenced me in so many ways that he doesn't even understand or know. And, you know, to be able to share the court with those guys one last time in this beautiful arena, though it didn't cap off with a win, I mean, it's still a tremendous memory or a tremendous moment to be able to share with guys like that, you know, who are just first-class guys, first and foremost, and then they're unbelievable players. So to be able to go out with those two, I mean, I wouldn't have it any other way. Of course I would want to win, but though that didn't happen, though that wasn't God's plan for today, I can still be content with knowing that I was able to share my last moments here in Milwaukee with those two guys. So I'm fortunate and blessed.
That's it.